Hola chicos, John de Marco Learning. Hoy vamos a hablar cómo se puede preparar por el examen AP Spanish Language. La primera cosa que tienes que hacer is to download the World Languages app from the College Board. You can do this in the App Store, you can do it in Google Play. Make sure you download the app and all the functionality works. What's really nice is once you're inside the app, you can practice recording yourself, you can practice your headphones and microphone, make sure everything works from a technological point of view. Remember, you cannot take this exam on any kind of desktop or laptop computer, only on a phone or a tablet. Y la segunda cosa que tienes que hacer es de preparar un espacio para tomar el examen. So preparing your space for the exam is actually harder than it seems. Again, you won't be able to use a desktop or laptop. You have to be on your phone. Will you have headphones? Will the headphones work on test day? Is the microphone reliable? Is your device charged? Is it a quiet place? Remember, the AP Spanish exam is only 22 minutes long this year. You're only gonna be speaking for 3 minutes and 40 seconds. 5 20-second segments as part of the conversation, and 2 full minutes of speaking for the presentación oral, the oral presentation. That's a really short exam, so you want to make sure whether you're taking this in a car or in your basement or in your bedroom that your space is organized. What kinds of papers will you have in front of you? What kinds of notes will you take? One thing to think about, guys, is the actual mechanics, like the choreography of the exam. If you're at a desk and you have your phone there, let's say you have headphones you plug in, you're all set up and your hands free, right? So you're working through the app, pressing the buttons, but that frees up room for you to write on pen and paper or to even work off of a computer. Remember, this is an open book, open note exam, but you need to think about what your space will look like. So literally clear your desk and imagine where your phone will be situated, where your papers or computer will be situated, and how you're going to do well on this exam by taking notes and responding to the tasks they give you. Y la tercera cosa que puedes hacer antes del examen es de practicar con los ejemplos del sitio de web de College Board. Remember guys, even though most of the exam, the multiple choice, the writing, the long writing, all of that's gone, the actual tasks you have, the conversation and the oral presentation, are basically the same as other years. You're only going to hear the instructions. The instructions will be read to you in English and in Spanish multiple times. You won't be working from print copies of anything, but the task is the same. And if you look on the College Board's website, they have examples from several previous years in the exact same format. They have sample student responses. They have scoring commentary, guidelines, really everything you need to see how people have done well in this exam. And let me say something important about this exam. A lot of people have told me, well, I don't really have a very good Spanish accent. I don't really believe in myself. That's the number one problem you need to overcome on test day. This is not about your accent. This is not about whether you sound like yo me llamo John, yo soy de los Estados Unidos, or you sound like somebody who's lived in Cuba for 20 years. What you need to focus on is your ability to answer the questions they give you, fill up as much time as you can, and structure your response clearly. Take a look at those College Board samples. You can see native Spanish speakers with really great accents who don't really answer the question that's given, don't use up all the time, and don't structure their responses. So do what you can to focus on the response that you can do, and trust your training, trust all the hard work and practice you've done, and make sure that, again, you take advantage of the resources that are out there. A lot has changed about this exam, but the Spanish language has not changed. The format of the exam for the oral presentation and for the conversation, those haven't changed either. So go into test day ready to succeed. Que tengas buena suerte en el día de examen.